Hello, and welcome to this digital learning conversation between our group of Year 6 learners and Mr. Penfold, our digital leader. Today's conversation will focus on how they have used Teams for live lessons. Incorporating a live lesson each day supported all learners across the school to have daily teaching on key aspects of their learning. By seeing the teacher and fellow peers, this supported the well-being for all. Practices that occur in the classroom were transferred to the remote learning. By sharing whole class feedback, all children understood their next steps in their learning.
Hello, Year 6. So we're going to have a conversation today about our team's live lessons and how they have benefited our learning over the last few weeks, and particularly in lockdown. So to start off and think about our learning, how has the team's live lessons supported our learning? Emma, kick us off.
It helped us because we didn't miss out on face-to-face learning and we were still given the help that we would have been given if we were in the classroom.
Okay, so actually, almost the classroom was the same to that online classroom that you had available. Gilly.
Yeah, like if we needed help and everything that we did was explained clearly, as though we would have been in school, but actually we're still at home. Just sat in front of a computer, but actually, we're still getting the same education as if we were at school, which was really good, so we didn't miss out.
So, how was that learning explained clearly, Imi?
Well, what this do instead of just telling it to us and just letting us do it, she explained it just in steps and slowly so we can understand it.
Was there particular things that Miss G used that supported that, Thomas?
Yeah, she used, so she split, didn't split her, she shared her screen and she made a little PowerPoint each day and she went through the PowerPoint with us slowly so we couldn't, and we had questions after every single, like every couple of slides.
So that helped to break down the steps, whether you were learning. I know you've been learning about that tricky concept of algebra, with that. Gilly, did you want to add more to that?
Yeah, and because like we've been learning algebra, which is quite difficult to learn straight up, and we had different function machines, and it was just tiny steps every day, and then you could build up to be able to do it more. And if that's what we had done with school, in school, we've done it out school as well.
So it just felt like the same experience in a classroom, but
Yeah.
actually just online instead. So what skills did it help you to learn? What did you enable, what skills did you learn through these Teams online lessons? Emma, kick us off.
Well, firstly, we learned how to do all the different things on Teams, like raise our hand, use the chat, reply to messages using emotions. But another skill we learned is to mature more being online.
Why was it important to do the raise hand feature? Imi.
Well, it was important to do that. So if everyone sort of just shouted out, Miss G wouldn't know what we're saying. So we raised our hand to make sure it went one at a time.
So the tech was actually, benefiting in that way because actually then Miss G knew who had the answer and she could choose on particular people. Any other skills that you learned, Thomas?
We learned how to practice splitting our screen and opening up a tab and also getting set up and knowing where everything is, so when we start the day, we know where the assignment will come up, we know where our extra learning is and all that.
Was there anything in particular that was possibly a challenge that you learned as a skill, Gilly?
Yeah, because when you had, like, if you had technical difficulties or your Wi-Fi cut out or you couldn't see someone, it was just being resilient and patient that you leave and rejoin, and then hopefully it'll be better than what it was, and I think that was probably a challenge for a lot of people.
So actually sometimes it didn't 100% work, but actually you had to have resilience to overcome those barriers and those challenges in a as well. So what was exciting about those team live lessons? What did you love about those team live lessons? Emma?
It was nice to see everyone each day, because I think it was last lockdown, or the one we had last year around this time, we wouldn't really see anyone on a FaceTime call. But at least with this lockdown, every day we'd see one or people, and it would just support our well-being.
And you felt actually that seeing everyone each day was possibly a real bonus, and actually you felt as if you were possibly in the classroom with that. Imi?
Well, occasionally Miss G would ask us to put something in the chat, so we didn't. It was really nice to just see other people's ideas, because at school we wouldn't be looking in their books all the time.
Absolutely. And building on that, actually you can see all the different ideas, and it brings about that chance that you can see what other people have suggested where we wouldn't necessarily get chance in other situations. Jilly, did you want to add more?
Yeah, and there was also something where it's almost like you could almost give each other praise. So say someone has something in the chat or an idea, and then you would reply with a thumbs up or something, and you just, that kind of makes you feel like you've done something well, which is quite nice as well.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, lots of great things in which we learnt across the team's live lessons. And I think that overarching feature that it supported the well-being of everyone, and actually it, you were always together as a class, was a really important feature of how it supported us all. So thank you very much, Year 6.
This was a digital learning conversation between learners and staff at Cornerstone C of E Primary in Hampshire in the UK. To find out more about how we are using digital technology to enhance teaching and learning at our school, please get in contact with us.